Dominicans in Rwanda. Gospel Meditation, Saturday, 13th week in Ordinary Time, 2020. New wine will flow. The prophet Amos and Jesus assured that the new wine should flow in those days when the bridegroom is with the wedding guest. This can hurt sensitive hearts who think either of the punishment against alcohol consumers or of the Eucharist when we talk about wine. It is true that from a religious point of view, wine takes on an eschatological symbolism to announce God's punishment against those who offend him. They risk drinking from the cup of divine anger. Religious symbolism also underlines the new covenant concluded in Jesus as a new wine, which is a sign of the joy achieved by the coming of the Messiah. It is also true that wine goes beyond the context of symbols to refer to the historical institution of the Eucharist. Before drinking new wine in the kingdom of the Father, the Christian will drink throughout the days from wine become the shed blood of Christ. However, the evocation of the word wine by Amos and by Jesus in today's readings also conveys a message particularly relevant in the reality of everyday life. Wine, everything that goes with it, and the protocol that surrounds it play a very positive role in human growth and development and social well-being. Wine delights the heart and creates fraternal communion by quenching thirst and restoring life when thirsty and hungry. It is a sign of prosperity and sharing that makes life pleasant when it is worn out with sobriety. In other words, in life, dark and painful things like the hunger that tormented the disciples of Jesus or the exiled people in Amos' time are never lacking. But it is very important to cling on the positive side of events if we want to grow physically and spiritually. Fasting, asceticism, and other forms of piety must be well understood and practiced humanly. May the Lord keep us safe from alcohol abuse. May the new wine of Christ flow abundantly among